Hello everyone. In the last class I have given complete information about the basics of financial statements. I hope you got clarity. Okay? Financial statements such as trading account, profit and loss account, balance sheet, the complete information, the basic information I have given in the last class. In this class I am going to explain problems on final accounts. Okay, problems are very important in the examination point of view, so all of you listen carefully. So there are two models in final accounts: final accounts with adjustments, final accounts without adjustments. In the first class I am going to explain final accounts without adjustments. Clear? Okay. And before coming to the problem, just listen few words, then you can easily understand. There are three components in final accounts. Three components, see here: trading account, profit and loss account, balance sheet. Three components. Okay, trading account. In the trading account, according to the format of trading account, debit side we have to record opening stock, purchases and direct expenses. Direct expenses means manufacturing expenses. Credit side we record only two items: sales and closing stock. Clear? Next, second component in final accounts, profit and loss account. According to the format of profit and loss account, debit side we record all indirect expenses. Indirect expenses means office expenses. Credit side we record indirect incomes. Clear? And we record gross profit and gross loss also, which are taken from trading account. Clear? Next, third component in final accounts, balance sheet. Balance sheet, this is not an account. Okay, so we should not write both sides DR and CR. This is sheet, a statement. So all left hand side, right hand side. Left hand side we record liabilities and capital. Liabilities and capital only. Liabilities include short term liabilities and long term liabilities. And right hand side we record assets, only assets. Assets include current assets, fixed assets and tangible assets. Current assets means these are very short moving assets. It can't continue for long period. It can't stay in the organization for long period. Next, fixed assets. As the name indicates, fixed, these assets are used by the organization for long period. Long period. Next, intangible assets. Intangible assets, intangibility means these assets we can't see and touch. But these assets are very important to get success. So these are also considered as assets. We record balance sheet in the balance sheet right hand side. What are intangible assets? Goodwill, patents, trademarks and copyrights. So very important. Trading account, opening stock, purchases, direct expenses. Credit side, sales, closing stock. Profit and loss account, debit side, all indirect expenses. Credit side, indirect incomes. Balance sheet, left hand side, capital liabilities. Right hand side, assets. Clear? Okay. This is the problem we are going to discuss. Note down all of you the problem. From the following ledger balances, prepare final accounts. Final accounts. Final accounts means it has three components: trading account, P&L account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet. Clear? Opening stock, wages, sales, bank loan, coal and coke, purchases, repairs, carries, income tax paid, debtors, leasehold premises, cash in hand, plant and machinery, లూజ్ టూల్స్, లైటింగ్, క్రెడిటార్స్, క్యాపిటల్, మిస్లేనియస్ రిసీప్ట్స్, ఆఫీస్ సాలరీస్, ఆఫీస్ ఫర్నిచర్, పేటెంట్స్, గుడ్ విల్, క్యాష్ అట్ బ్యాంక్. ఓకే, దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఐటమ్స్, దీస్ ఆర్ లెడ్జర్ బ్యాలెన్సెస్. అండ్ లిజన్ వన్స్ అగెయిన్ బిఫోర్ గోయింగ్ టు బిగిన్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్. లిజన్ వన్స్ అగెయిన్, ద ఐటమ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ అపీరింగ్ హియర్ ఇన్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్ వీ షుడ్ రికార్డ్ ఓన్లీ వన్ టైమ్, ఓన్లీ వన్ టైమ్, ఓన్లీ వన్ టైమ్. ఏ ద ట్రేడింగ్ అకౌంట్ ఆర్ ప్రాఫిట్ అండ్ లాస్ అకౌంట్ ఆర్ బ్యాలెన్స్ షీట్ వీ షుడ్ రికార్డ్ ఓన్లీ వన్ టైమ్. సో సీ హియర్ హౌ టు రికార్డ్ ద ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ ఇన్ ట్రేడింగ్ అకౌంట్, ప్రాఫిట్ అండ్ లాస్ అకౌంట్ అండ్ బ్యాలెన్స్ షీట్. హెడ్డింగ్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. ఫ్రమ్ ద ఫాలోయింగ్ లెడ్జర్ బ్యాలెన్సెస్ ప్రిపేర్ ఫైనల్ అకౌంట్స్. ఓకే, ఫైనల్ అకౌంట్స్, సో ట్రేడింగ్ అండ్ ప్రాఫిట్ అండ్ లాస్ అకౌంట్ వీ ప్రిపేర్ టుగెదర్. సో ట్రేడింగ్ అండ్ ప్రాఫిట్ అండ్ లాస్ అకౌంట్ ఆఫ్ పర్సన్ నేమ్ నాట్ గివెన్, లీవ్ ఇట్. అండ్ సెకండ్ లైన్ ఫర్ ద ఇయర్ ఎండింగ్ 31st 12, ఇయర్ ఆల్సో నాట్ గివెన్. ఫైనల్ అకౌంట్స్ ఆర్ ప్రిపేర్డ్ ఓన్లీ ఎట్ ద ఇయర్ ఎండింగ్. సో డేట్ హెడ్డింగ్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ అలాంగ్ విత్ డేట్, బట్ పర్సన్ నేమ్ నాట్ మెన్షన్ ఆర్ కంపెనీ నేమ్ ఆల్సో నాట్ మెన్షన్ ఇన్ దిస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్, డేట్ ఆల్సో నాట్ గివెన్, లీవ్ ఇట్. దిస్ ఈజ్ ద ఫార్మెట్ ఆఫ్ ట్రేడింగ్ అండ్ ప్రాఫిట్ అండ్ లాస్ అకౌంట్. ఓకే, హోల్డ్ ద పేజ్, యు కెన్ గెట్ 2 ఈక్వల్ పార్ట్స్. లెఫ్ట్ హ్యాండ్ సైడ్ డెబిట్ సైడ్, సో డిఆర్. రైట్ హ్యాండ్ సైడ్ క్రెడిట్ సైడ్, సో సిఆర్. పర్టిక్యులర్స్, అమౌంట్ విత్ ఇన్ బ్రాకెట్స్ రూపీస్, డెబిట్ సైడ్ అమౌంట్. పర్టిక్యులర్స్, అమౌంట్ విత్ ఇన్ బ్రాకెట్స్ రూపీస్. ఓకే, ఫస్ట్ అకార్డింగ్ టు ద ఫార్మెట్, ఓపెనింగ్ స్టాక్, పర్చేజెస్, నెట్ పర్చేజెస్ అండ్ ఆన్ డైరెక్ట్ ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్, క్రెడిట్ సైడ్ సేల్స్ అండ్ క్లోజింగ్ స్టాక్. ఓకే, ఫస్ట్ ఓపెనింగ్ స్టాక్ 2. వీ హ్యావ్ టు బిగిన్ ద ట్రాన్సాక్షన్స్ విత్ 2 డెబిట్ సైడ్, క్రెడిట్ సైడ్ బై 2. ఓపెనింగ్ స్టాక్ అమౌంట్ 3600. నెక్స్ట్ యాజ్ పర్ ద ఫార్మెట్, సెకండ్ వీ రికార్డ్ పర్చేజెస్. వేర్ పర్చేజెస్? పర్చేజెస్ 2, పర్చేజెస్, పర్చేజెస్. బిఫోర్ ఎంటర్ ద అమౌంట్ పర్చేజెస్ వీ షుడ్ చెక్ ఇట్ వన్స్, పర్చేజ్ రిటర్న్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఆర్ నాట్. లిజన్ వన్స్, బిఫోర్ రికార్డ్ ద అమౌంట్ పర్చేజెస్ వీ షుడ్ చెక్ ఇట్ వన్స్, రిటర్న్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఆర్ నాట్. ఇఫ్ రిటర్న్స్ ఆర్ గివెన్ ఇన్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్ వీ రికార్డ్ ఇన్నర్ కాలమ్ అమౌంట్ అండ్ వీ షుడ్ డిడక్ట్ పర్చేజ్ రిటర్న్స్ ఫ్రమ్ పర్చేజ్. నెట్ పర్చేజెస్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు పోస్ట్ హియర్. సేమ్ ఫ్యాషన్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఫాలో ఫర్ సేల్స్ ఆల్సో. ఓకే, సో ఇన్ దిస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ పర్చేజ్ రిటర్న్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ గివెన్. సో 2 పర్చేజెస్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ఇన్నర్ కాలమ్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ఔటర్ కాలమ్. పర్చేజెస్ 15,000. ఓకే, అండ్ థర్డ్ యాజ్ పర్ ద ఫార్మెట్ వీ రికార్డ్ ఆల్ డైరెక్ట్ ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్. వాట్ ఆర్ డైరెక్ట్ ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్? డైరెక్ట్ ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్ మీన్స్ మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్. మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్, ఫ్యాక్టరీ ఎక్స్పెన్సెస్, ఓపెనింగ్ స్టాక్ రికార్డెడ్, వేజెస్. వేజెస్ ఆర్ నథింగ్ బట్ దీస్ ఆర్ ద రిమ్యునరేషన్, దిస్ ఈస్ ద రిమ్యునరేషన్ గివెన్ బై ద ఆర్గనైజేషన్ టు ద లేబరర్స్, ఫ్యాక్టరీ లేబరర్స్. దిస్ ఈస్ మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ ఎక్స్పెన్స్, డైరెక్ట్ ఎక్స్పెన్స్. సో వీ రికార్డ్ హియర్ 2 వేజెస్, వేజెస్ 2000. నెక్స్ట్ సేల్స్, సేల్స్ ఇండైరెక్ట్ ఎక్స్పెన్స్, బ్యాంక్ లోన్. సో విల్ బి షోన్ ఇన్ ద బ్యాలెన్స్ షీట్. వై? బికాస్ దిస్ ఈజ్ లయబిలిటీ. కోల్ అండ్ కోక్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్. So to manufacture the goods, they should use coal and coke for running the machineries. Coal. So this is direct expense. Coal and coke, 600. Next, purchases recorded. Repairs, indirect expense. Carriage, indirect expense. Income tax paid, indirect expense. Debtors, asset. Leasehold premises, asset. Cash in hand, asset. Plant and machinery, asset. Fixed asset. Loose tools, asset. Lighting means electricity charges. So this is indirect expense. Creditors liability, capital liability, receipts. This is it will be shown in the P&L account, profit and loss account. Office salaries, this is expenditure, indirect expense. Furniture asset, patents and goodwill, these are intangible assets. Cash at bank, this is asset. Okay, so over. And credit side, as per the format, credit side, first we record sales as the first item. Sales. Sales. Sales 24,000. So before enter the amount, we should check it once. Sales returns are there or not. If returns are there, we record sales items in the inner column. We deduct sales returns from sales. Net sales, we should record outer column. But in this problem, sales returns are not given. So sales 24,000. Next, buy, second item, closing stock. But closing stock is also not given. So leave it. Okay. So now we add both sides. Credit side we have 24,000. And debit side total balance 21,200. 21,200. So, trading account, credit side has more balance in the debit side. More balance we record in both sides. 24,000 and 24,000. Okay, credit side has means these are credit side incomes. Debit side expenses. Incomes are more than debit side. The balance amount is called to gross profit. Carry down. Difference between debit balance and credit balance. So difference 24,000 minus 21,200. 2,800. Clear? We prepare trading and profit and loss account together. Next, profit and loss account. To gross profit, carry down. So, gross profit, it is transferred to the P&L account, profit and loss account. So, to gross profit carried down by gross profit brought down. It is to be transferred to P&L account, gross mark 2,800. Okay, listen once, trading account over. So we are going to prepare P&L account, profit and loss account. We prepare trading and profit and loss account together. Okay. And this is a profit and loss account debit side. All indirect expenses we record at debit side. All indirect incomes we record at credit side. So what are indirect incomes and what are indirect incomes and indirect expenses? Okay. So, opening stock. Opening stock over. We should record only one time. Opening stock recorded. So, wages also recorded. Sales also recorded. Okay. Coal and coke also recorded. And purchases also recorded. Clear? Okay. So, next one, bank loan. So, it will be shown bank loan. This is liability. It will be shown in the balance sheet. Repairs. This is indirect expenses. To repairs. Repairs 400. Next, carriage. Carriage is nothing but transport charges. Indirect expenses. To carriage 300. Next, income tax paid. This is also indirect expense, office expenses. Two, income tax paid, 300. Next, debtors. Debtors, asset. Leasehold premises, asset. Cash in hand also, asset. Next, plant and machinery. Plant and machinery, asset. Loose tools, asset. Lighting, this is expenditure. Two, lighting. Four, 60. Next, creditors liability, capital liability, miscellaneous receipts. All indirect expenses, debit side. All indirect incomes, credit side. Miscellaneous receipts. Miscellaneous receipts. Amount 120. Next, office salaries. Salaries. Office expenditure. Indirect expenses. Two, office salaries, 500. Next, furniture asset. Patents, goodwill, asset. Intangible asset. Cash at bank also asset. Okay. So, we have posted all the items. Now, we add both sides. Credit side, we have 2,920. 2,920. Debit side, we have only 1,960. Total, 1,960. So, credit side has more balance than debit side. More balance we have to record both sides. Credit side has more balance. So, 2,920, 2,920. Okay. So, credit side means income more than expenditure. The balance is called profit. To net profit. Now, we deduct 1,960 from 2,920. Balance amount 960 rupees net profit. Incomes are more than expenditure. So, net profit. Here also in trading account, incomes are more than expenditure. Gross profit. So, trading profit and loss account over. Next, third component in final accounts, balance sheet. Now, we prepare balance sheet. Heading very important. Balance sheet. Within brackets for the year ending 31st 12, not given date, not given. Okay, so this is not an account, so we should not write left hand side DR, right hand side CR. So, this is left hand side, right hand side. Left hand side, liabilities, amount, rupees. Right hand side, assets, amount, rupees. This is the format of balance sheet. Okay. So, left hand side, capital and liabilities we record. In the left hand side, assets we record in the right hand side. Clear? Capital liabilities left hand side, assets right hand side. So, first one, capital. Where is capital? Capital. Capital. So, capital. So, note down, this is inner column, this is outer column. Capital. 8,000. As per the format, add net profit to capital. Net profit 960. Okay. So, before record the item in the outer column, we should check it once. Drawings are there or not. If drawings are given in the problem, we should deduct drawings from this amount. Remaining balance we have to record outer column. Okay, but in this problem drawings are not given. Owner own investment not given. So that 8,960. Okay. So we recorded capital over. Lighting also over. Office salaries recorded. Okay. Income tax paid we recorded. Repairs also we recorded. Carriages also we recorded. All these items we should record only one time. In trading account or profit and loss account or balance sheet. So here bank loan. Bank loan, this is liability. Liability side. Bank loan. 880. Okay. Give tick mark. Next, debtors. Debtor asset 4,000. Leasehold premises means business area. This is also asset. Leasehold premises asset 1,200 over. Next, cash in hand 40 rupees recorded. Plant and machinery 1,500. Next, loose tools. This is also means spare parts. This is also asset. Loose tools 360. Lighting recorded. Creditors liability. Why creditors liability? Why debtors asset? I have given complete information in the last video. 1,600. Next, miscellaneous receipts we recorded. Office furniture asset. ₹120. Next, patents, goodwill, intangible assets. Patents 200, goodwill 3,000. Last, cash at bank also asset 1,020. Okay, we recorded all the items. We recorded all the items in the balance sheet. Now we add both sides. Okay, both sides, liability side 11,440. Asset side, this side also same amount, 11,440. So it is tally. It is same on both sides. 11,440. It means our balance sheet is correct. Okay. So like this, we have to prepare final accounts. Trading account. We prepare trading profit and loss account together. Trading account, continuation profit and loss account, and balance sheet. It should be tallied. Clear? And next problem. This is the second problem. See once. Note down all of you second problem. See in the books of Hari and Company, prepare trading profit and loss account and balance sheet for the year ending 31st March 2018 from the following particulars. Opening stock, salaries, sales, motor car, travelling expenses, cash in hand, capital, interest, bills receivables, wages, furniture and fixtures, sundry debtors, lighting, printing and stationery, postage, sales returns, purchases, commission paid, bank balance, advertisement, sundry creditors. Okay, so this is the second model problem. Final accounts, there are two models in final accounts: without adjustments, with adjustments. With adjustments, very important for examination point of view. So two adjustments are also given: adjustments, closing stock, outstanding salary. See once problem, no doubt. Clear? So how to prepare final account? Listen. Okay. Before coming to the problem, just listen once again. So here we prepare trading, profit and loss account and balance sheet. Okay. In trading account, we should write opening stock, purchases, all direct expenses at debit side. Direct expenses means manufacturing expenses. Sales and closing stock we record at credit side. Next, in profit and loss account, we should record all indirect expenses debit side, all indirect incomes credit side, and gross profit and gross loss, which is brought down from trading account, also we should record gross profit credit side, gross loss debit side. Next, in balance sheet, we take all assets and liabilities. All assets right hand side, all liabilities left hand side. Clear? Along with the trial balance, two adjustments are given: closing stock and outstanding salaries. Okay, listen once. There is a simple route to prepare final accounts. Simple route. The items which are present in the trial balance, we record only one time. The items which are appearing here, we record only one time. In trading account or profit and loss account or balance sheet, only one time. Adjustments we record twice, two times. Because these are new transactions. Business transactions we record once in journal, second time in ledger. First we record in journal, second time in ledger. These are new transactions, so we record two times. Where we should record two times? Every business transaction has two accounts, we know well: debit account and credit account. So one time debit side and one time credit side. Okay, we record two times adjustments. All these items we record only one time: trading account or profit and loss account or balance sheet. Adjustments we record two times. Okay, two times every transaction has two accounts: debit account and credit account. So we record one time debit side, one time credit side. One time debit side, trading profit and loss account or balance sheet, one time debit side, or trading profit and loss account credit side or liability side. Listen once. Trading profit and loss account debit side or liability side, or trading profit and loss account credit side or liability side. Okay, so we have to record two times: one time in debit side, one time in credit side. Clear? So this is the format of trading profit and loss account. We prepare trading profit and loss account together. So in the books of Hari and Company, name very important. Trading and profit and loss account of Hari and Company for the year ending, date also given: 31st March 2018. This is the format. Okay, particulars amount rupees. Left hand side debit side, right hand side credit side. So as per the format, first we record trading account opening stock. Two, opening stock 5000. only one time we record. Next, salaries. Salaries, this is, it will be shown in P&L account, profit and loss account. This is indirect. First, opening stock we record. Next, purchases. Purchases, where purchases? Purchases. So, two purchases. Purchases, 25,000. So, before recording purchases, we should check it once. Purchase returns are there or not. If returns are there, we should record inner column and deduct returns from purchases. Net purchases we should record. But in this problem, purchase returns are not given. Okay. So, purchases 25,000. Next, direct expenses. Direct expenses, salary, indirect, sales, credit side. This is not motor car. Okay. This is asset. Traveling expenses, indirect, cash in hand asset, capital liability, interest. Okay, this is expenditure, indirect expenses, bills receivable asset, wages, two wages, 2000, furniture and fixtures asset, sundry debtors asset, lighting indirect expenses, printing stationery indirect expenses, postage indirect expenses, sales returns, purchases recorded, purchases and wages are also recorded, commission paid indirect, bank balance asset, advertisement indirect, sundry creditors liability, leave it over. Next, credit side, buy as per the format we record as the first item, sales 70,400 we record in the inner column because sales returns are given in this problem, sales returns. So, less sales returns 6,000. So, net sales we record outer column 64,400. Clear? So, we recorded sales returns and sales also. Next, closing stock. As per the format, as the second item we record closing stock adjustment. Two times we record. One time credit side, trading profit and loss account, credit side. Buy closing stock 40,000. Okay, closing stock. Two times we record. One time debit side, one time credit side. One time debit side, either trading profit and loss account, debit side or credit side. We recorded credit side. Now, once again we record in balance sheet. Okay. So, now we add both sides. Both sides, credit side we have 1,04,400. 1,04,400. And debit side we have only 32,000. Total 32,000. Means credit side has more balance than debit side. Incomes are more than expenditure. So the balance is called, same amount we record, 1,04,400. The difference amount, gross profit. Gross profit carried down. Okay, now we deduct 32,000 from 1,04,400. Balance 72,400. This amount to be transferred to P&L account, profit and loss account. By gross profit brought down 72,400. Clear? Trading account over. But we should prepare trading profit and loss account together. Now we are going to prepare P&L account. Okay. In profit and loss account, indirect expenses debit side, indirect incomes credit side. Okay. So, salary indirect expenditure, but it has adjustment, we should record two times. So, salary, the item has adjustment. So, we should record inner column, 500 rupees. Means company already paid 500 rupees salaries. and outstanding salary means still it has to pay. Outstanding means still it has to pay 150 rupees. It has to pay. So we should add already paid. It has to pay. So that add outstanding. Outstanding 150 total. Total company salary expenditure 650. Okay, salaries over. Motor car asset, traveling expenses 2. Traveling expenses 700. Cash in hand asset, capital liability, interest 2. Interest. Company paid interest. So that this is indirect expenditure 1800. Bills receivable asset, wages recorded, furniture fixtures asset, sundry debtors asset, lighting, electricity charges, lighting, indirect office expenses, indirect expenses, lighting 350. Printing stationery, this is also indirect expenditure, printing and stationery 100 over. So this is a lighting recorded, printing stationery recorded, postage, postage also, postal charges, office expenses, indirect expenses. Next, sales returns recorded, purchase recorded, commission paid, this is also expenditure, indirect expenditure, office expenditure, commission paid 1500. Okay, bank balance asset, advertisement expenses also office expenses. Advertisement 1000. Okay, recorded. Sundry creditors liability over. Okay, so we recorded all. Recording over. Okay. Now, we should check it once. Adjustments, we should record two times. One time in trading profit and loss account, one time in balance sheet. We recorded or not? Check it once. Closing stock, we recorded. Okay, trading account. And as outstanding salaries also, we recorded. Okay, one time trading and profit and loss account, we recorded. Now, we balance both. So, compared to debit side, credit side has more balance. So, the amount we record both sides, 72,400 and 72,400. Credit side we have 72,400 and debit side we have the total 6,150. Means, okay, income is more than expenditure. The balance is called net profit. Now, we deduct debit side balance from credit side balance. 72,400 minus 6,150. Balance 66,250. This is net profit. It should be transferred to the capital account. Transfer to capital account. Okay. So, trading profit and loss account over. Next, balance sheet. Balance sheet. Balance sheet or abbreviated form of balance sheet B/S. Both are correct. Balance sheet of Hari. Heading very important. Hari and company for the year ending 31st March 3, March 3, 2018. This is balance sheet. This is the format of balance sheet. Left hand side, this is not an account. This is a statement. So, we should not write left hand side top corner DR, right hand side top corner CR. Left hand side liabilities, right hand side assets. Amount, rupees, amount within brackets, rupees. Clear? All liabilities and capital we record left hand side. All assets we record right hand side. So what are assets and what are liabilities? See here. As per the format, first we record capital. Capital, owner, investment, capital. So where is capital? Capital. Traveling expenses we recorded in P&L account. So capital 30,000 record in the inner column. Capital, okay, 30,000. And next, as per the format, we add net profit to the capital. Net profit 66,250 net profit. Okay, before enter this amount in the outer column, we should check it once. Drawings are there or not? If drawings are given in the problem, we should deduct drawings from this amount. Okay, remaining balance we should record outer column. But in this problem, drawings are not given. Okay, so that 96,250 total. Next, opening stock recorded, salaries recorded, sales recorded, motor car asset. Motor car 25,000 over. Traveling expenses recorded, cash in hand asset. Cash in hand, this is asset, 5,000. Next, capital recorded, interest we already recorded in P&L account. Bills receivable, company will receive bills, this is asset, bills receivable. Bills, $4,000. Next, wages recorded, furniture asset, furniture and fixtures, furniture asset, $3,600. Debtors, always asset, we should record always left hand, right hand side assets. Debtors 14,000. Next, lighting recorded, printing and stationery recorded, postage recorded, sales returns recorded, purchases recorded, commission paid recorded, bank balance, this is asset, bank balance 10,000. Okay, advertisement recorded, creditors liability, means company has to pay this amount, this is liability, 5,200. Debtors means company can recover this amount from others, 14,000, this is asset. Okay, so we recorded all these items. Okay, next, adjustments we record two times, one time trading profit and loss account, one time balance sheet. So closing stock already we recorded credit side. Okay, credit side over. And one time we record debit side. Debit side, all assets debit, all liabilities credit. You are familiar, we already discussed in trial balance. Okay, so that closing stock we record in asset side. Okay, asset side means debit side, liability side means credit side, this is credit side, this is debit side. Okay, closing stock 40,000, two times credit side we recorded, asset means debit side also we recorded, two times over, one debit and one credit. Outstanding salaries, this is also we should record two times, one debit side and one credit side. So we recorded debit side, we recorded, and the second time credit side. Credit side means liability side. Outstanding salaries means company has to pay 150 rupees. So this is liability to the company. So we recorded, we posted all these. Now we add both sides. Both sides, liability side 1,01,600. and asset side also same amount 1,01,600. Clear? So it is tally. So it is the same in both sides, 1,01,600, 1,01,600. So it means our balance sheet is correct like this. So we have to prepare trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet. Clear? This is a previous question paper problem. Okay?